suppose we all thought that, one way or another.
In the culminant moments of World War II, humanity witnessed a moment that changed the course of history forever, the Trinitite nuclear test. On July 16, 1945, near Alamogordo, New Mexico, the first atomic bomb was detonated as part of the Manhattan Project, led by the brilliant physicist J. Robert Oppenheimer. Little did anyone know that this test would leave behind a tangible relic, one that reminds us of the dangerous power contained in nuclear detonations. This in the form of a colloquially known mineral known as trinitite. So, how is trinitite formed? The actual process is complicated. However, in simple terms, the detonation provided two things, heat and pressure, which allowed the already present sand, a common silicate compound, to recrystallize itself. This process is commonly known as vitrification, given the fact that it became a glassy type of substance. Therefore, trinitite is technically not a mineral. It is in fact classified as an unofficial mineral, given that it is a vitreous substance. Trinitite also bears a faint radioactive signature as a consequence of being composed of a mixture of radioactive byproducts. However, the radiation is faint enough to be handled with care as long as it isn't inhaled as dust particles. Today, the Trinity test site is now restricted and inaccessible to the public, making authentic trinitite a rare and treasure find for collectionists. In conclusion, trinitite isn't like any other compound, as it carries a very dark and heavy symbolic meaning, one that would mark a before and after in both human history and in the history of warfare.